Hey guys, Wild Willie here. Today we're going to show you how to change the front tire off of your motorcycle. It's going to be some fun stuff. So the specific model of bike that we're working with here is a 1998 Honda Valkyrie. So while it is going to be specific to this bike, these are still going to be general principles that you can apply to pretty much any motorcycle. You will just want to make sure that you have your own user manual handy or service manual handy, just so you can check things like torque specs and things like that. So here is the bike that we're working on. Beautiful bike, beautiful bike. So first thing we're going to do, we're just going to crack this axle nut loose. This happens to be a 22 millimeter nut that I'm using just a ratchet for. So I'll go ahead and crack that loose and then move on to the next step. All right, so it did not give it up easy, but we were able to crack that bolt loose. So there you go right there. So I'll just keep on unscrewing that and remove that. All right, now that we get that loose, we're gonna turn our eyes over to the brakes and we're just gonna go ahead and remove these two bolts right here so we can remove these brakes off of here. And as we take it off, we're just gonna kind of wiggle a little bit just to leave us a little bit of space so that it's easier for us to get it back on afterward in between the brake pads. So we'll get these two bolts off right here and slide that brake off. Okay, we got the brakes off. Now we're just gonna go ahead and repeat that on the other side. Same process. So now that we got the brakes off, we're gonna go ahead and take out these two Allen bolts right here that really tighten and hold the fork in place with the axle. Want to be really super careful you don't strip this. And then also just a quick trick, you can know to give yourself a little bit of extra leverage if you put your Allen wrench in there and then grab just any type of other wrench and just pull out like that. Gives you a lot more leverage and you're able to typically crack that loose without, you know, with less danger of stripping it. So I'm gonna go ahead and crack these two loose and then remove them and then do the exact same thing on the other side as well. All right, now next what we're gonna do is pull out the axle here. So that's actually a 17 millimeter hex key, whatever you wanna call it, or Allen key. Don't happen to have one handy, but I do have this right here that just fits in there perfectly. So I'm just gonna use this and then just twist this around. And there aren't any threads in here, but as you twist it, it'll just slowly start to come out. I've only turned it about once, and you can see that it's already started coming out here. So you're just gonna turn this counterclockwise, just like so, and that'll just keep on coming out for you. And then your tire will be disconnected. One thing that you wanna just keep an eye on as you're unhooking this is right here, you have your miles per hour cable, or your speedometer cable, whatever you want to call it. So this bit right here is gonna come loose and you just want to kind of note in the position that it's in, so that way you can put it back in that same position. Put it back in that same position when you put the axle back in again. One thing that'll help that I didn't mention before is you want to lower your jack stand just enough so that your tires resting on the concrete as you're pulling that axle out. Otherwise, if you have it lifted too high in the air, it's just gonna put a lot more weight on that axle, on that tire, and it'd be a harder, more difficult task to coax it out. And we just slowly turn that out, we're patient with it, and we're able to get that axle out. And again, you just wanna note the position of this speedometer contraption as you pulled out, so that way you can put it back in the same position afterward. And your tire is now free and ready to swap out your rubber on your tire. All right, so got that new tire seated on the rim. Kind of a pain in the ass if you don't have the right tools for it. Quick tip is Les Schwab and other like auto places that do tires, typically they'll be willing to pop the new rubber, take off the old tire off the rim and put the new tire on for you. Lots of times they'll do it for pretty cheap or free or anything like that. So if you don't have all the tools that you need to pop off that tire, find out one of those local places that are near you. Also, I'm going to link a video in here, just in the description, for another YouTube video that another guy did. It's actually really great, and I can't explain it better than he can. So if you are going to do it yourself, he explains all the tools you need and how to do it. So you'll see that link in here. But now we're going to go ahead and put that tire back on, just reverse steps, everything that we did to take it off. Okay, so we got our speedometer cable back in place, started sliding the axle in. Here, there's a little spacer I didn't show you earlier, that we just want to make sure that spacer is in place. And then with that, we will go ahead and slide that axle all the way through. Took a little finesse, but I was able to get that axle bar back in there with the the speedometer piece in place, your spacer in place, and then that's that screw that we took off initially. Go ahead and tighten this and get this in place as well. Now that we got this axle bolt back in place, we're gonna go ahead and put in all of our Allen bolts, two on each side, two here, two on the other side. We're gonna tighten those. Make sure you look up the torque spec for those. You don't wanna over torque it and tear up your threads. Sometimes the thread inside here is only aluminum versus like stainless steel bolts. So you'll actually tear up this thread before you tear up this thread. So you just wanna make sure you're not over torquing it. All right, now that we got all of our Allen bolts tightened on either side, we'll go ahead and put our brakes back in place, slide this back in and tighten up these two bolts that we removed previously, get the brakes back in place, and then we will repeat that same process on the other side. Okay, we were able to get brakes on this side back in place. Now we'll just do the same thing on this side. What's up, guys? Got a 1998 Honda Valkyrie, six cylinder here. Previous customer just wanted a new front tire, swapped it out. Fun stuff.